for the biggest newsmakers is here on Michigan's Morning Show with Michael Patrick Shields.
Michael Patrick Shields is on the air.
Good morning, world.
Good morning, Michigan. A very pleasant Thursday to you. Michael Patrick Shields heard all across the state of Michigan. If you didn't stay up late last night, the Boston Bruins are the Stanley Cup champions, and there was violence and vandalism in Vancouver when the Canucks lost Game 7. It was 4-0, sort of an anticlimactic final yesterday, but the rioters overturned cars, set them on fire, shattered downtown shop windows, and threw bottles and bricks at police. They were there in riot gear, all because of a hockey game. And the mayor of Vancouver says that it's disgraceful and embarrassing, to say the least. Foreclosure filings fell across the United States in May. And here in Michigan, education was the one of the top topics yesterday. Anyway, they were talking about that bridge in Detroit. But the former Florida Governor Jeb Bush testified before a joint House and Senate Education Committee. He said afterward, ensuring every student gets a quality education is one of the biggest challenges facing the country. Here's what Governor Bush said about Governor Snyder's education reforms.
And the idea that this is comprehensive really matters. There's no one single fix to the systemic problems of education. But if you change the system, great teachers will excel and students will learn.
Governor Snyder pushing to restructure the teacher tenure system to have it based on performance and also create greater accountability for schools. And the Florida Governor Jeb Bush, who is the brother of George W. Bush and the son of George Herbert Walker Bush, said it's not a homogenized group of kids entering kindergarten every year. Kids come from all over the place, all different backgrounds, so varying strategies are needed.
Teachers are okay, every kid's going to be taught the same way. It doesn't work that way when you have the big range in learning capabilities that the kids start out at.
We'll get in touch with Michael Flanagan, the state superintendent of schools. He was with Jeb Bush yesterday and find out exactly how that all went and what it means now for Michigan legislatively. Will there be a little lift in the legislature, having been perhaps inspired by the success that Jeb Bush had in Florida when he was the first Republican governor to serve two consecutive terms there and sort of remade the entire education system in Florida. And it wasn't easy. He did it without raising taxes, too. What did we learn yesterday? That's what we'll want to know. Crystal Harris, who was engaged to Hugh Hefner. Now, Hugh is 85, and Crystal Harris is 25. And they were supposed to get married this weekend. It was going to be a big splashy thing in the backyard at the Playboy Mansion. She called it off, saying it's a mutual decision. And I guess she said she had a little trouble digesting the fact that she was going to be Mrs. Hefner. And apparently Hugh was going to continue his bachelor ways, having multiple girls. And she said that's not the lifestyle she wants to lead. You think she would have known that before she got engaged to Hugh Hefner. So they called off the wedding. 300 people were going to be there, all sorts of famous celebrities and all the rest. And interestingly, the Playboy edition that comes out this Friday, America's Princess, introducing Mrs. Crystal Hefner, is what it's still going to be on the newsstands. I'm beginning to wonder if this was all just a publicity stunt. There is some talk, too, that she wanted to have a reality show, $500,000 deal, all about her decision to scram, to call off the wedding. She knew it would be a media sensation. That's all being denied. But Crystal Harris, a comely blonde, if you will, was on the radio yesterday in Los Angeles talking about her decision. And does this sound like a woman who went through an emotional decision to call off a wedding only days before it?
Hi, I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm all right. Oh, you sound happy and chipper.
I'm doing okay.
Well, I'm just thinking about what's happening in your world and want to ask you, a few days out from this wedding over the weekend, tell everybody why you called it off.
I called it off because I didn't think it was the right thing for me to do. It was mutual between Hef and I. There was no fight. Mm-hmm. There was nothing. We sat down and we talked about it. And, you know, we just kind of asked ourselves, like, why are we doing this? And I don't know. For a while, I've been having second thoughts about everything. So I haven't been like really at peace with myself lately. So I just didn't think it was, you know, fair to him.
When did you start to have second thoughts about marrying him?
I mean, for a while now, I just, I don't know, it all happened so fast, and, you know, we were going to do, they were going to air a show on it, and it all just kind of, you know, it was all happening too fast for me, and I just sat back and just thought about it all, and, you know, is this what I wanted, and,
yeah.
You know, it wasn't.
You could tell in your heart it wasn't. And you said it was mutual, so he felt the same way or understood?
He understood, and we both agreed that it wasn't the best idea to get married. You know, he kind of told me that, you know, he was doing it for me because he thought it's what I wanted. And, you know, I told him it was all happening just so quick. And, you know, I told him that I just feel that I owed it to Hef and everyone there to do the right thing and move on.
Mm-hmm. There was no fight, as she said, because there were reports about a big fight and you guys had an issue and then somebody stormed out, but that's not the case. It sounds like it was very different from what the reports were.
Had you guys gone down the path of all the like traditional wedding stuff, like bridal showers or anything where there were gifts you have to return, or are people already in town that have to go home? Are you going to have like a little party, or what? Like, how will that be resolved?
I have about 15 relatives flying in from London, so I'm going to find something for them to do.
And how's he doing? How's Hef doing?
Hef's doing great. He's doing great.
Is he heartbroken?
I mean, he's okay. He's okay. You know, Hef's lifestyle isn't, you know, the most normal lifestyle, and that's the kind of thing also. I'm like, you know, this isn't the lifestyle for me, you know, multiple girls around all the time and, you know, the Playboy lifestyle. I don't know. I just wanted to be true to myself, and he's fine. He has really, you know, close people around him all the time. So
he'll be able to bounce back, I'm sure.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Why do we get the feeling we're all being suckered? Some of Hefner's friends are saying he's going to die of a broken heart at 85. I just get the feeling it's all a publicity stunt with the magazine coming out and the reality show and the whole thing. That's just me. Maybe I'm a little cynical, and maybe not. Art Prize closes today. If you want to be part of Art Prize, the exhibition opens September 21st, but the deadline is 5 o'clock today. So Hugh's prize, Hugh Hefner's arm candy, Crystal Harris, no longer will be walking down the aisle with him. Later on, we're going to talk about how President Obama, you know what, I'm not going to draw the connection. You can draw the connection yourself when you hear what the president is up to as soon as we get back. It's Michael Patrick Shields, Michigan's Morning Show.